For our project, we wanted to take what we had learned in this class and apply it to a real-life startup here at Iowa State. Midwest Beer Club was founded on the idea of having local beer hand-delivered cold to your doorstep. Think of it like an old Netflix subscription, but only for beer. Customers will create a beer profile, and Midwest Beer Club does the rest to find new local beers to try. Since it's not a brewing company and focuses on distribution, our project will focus on the delivery aspect of the company. So, sign us up and let's get started. Before we get ahead of ourselves, we should probably explain how we know where we are going. We used online demographic statistics and a group member from Ames to find areas that would most likely use this service. Then we chose 10 addresses. We also knew the location of the warehouse, so we created a matrix based off the time in between points because the delivery happens within a window of 3 hours. As for our code, we used Goosec as the solver. We had to declare all the possible combinations as variables, and then we had to set up the subtour constraint variables. Then came the minimization objective statement with all the times from the matrix as coefficients. As for the constraints, the first constraint is making sure it can only leave a node once. The other, make sure it only arrives at a node once. Lastly, the rest are eliminating subtours. For these 10 addresses, we got an objective value of 72 minutes. One of the challenging aspects of the project was making sure the subtour constraints were working properly. So we checked the path by finding the variables with the value 1, since all the location variables were binary. It turns out the constraints were working and there were no subtours. Pulling up the route on a map gives us a clear picture of how well the program did at minimizing the delivery route. So let's get back to where we were, out on the road. A delivery can go one of two ways. The first and preferred option is a perfect delivery. It's as smooth as ice, like the amazing and unnecessary slow-mo shot. It happens when a customer is home like they said they would be. They give Midwest Beer Club their ID to check, and the cold beer changes hands, and both sides are happy. On the other hand, when a customer isn't home and the stop was made without an exchange of beer, the stop was unnecessary. We wanted to explore this further to find the impact of a customer not being home and thus having to re-deliver the beer. We hoped to quantify this in dollars, so we ran multiple route simulations using the method previously explained. We ran the simulations in order to find out how much time missing a stop and adding a stop costed the company. So we ran multiple simulations to find a number that we thought was accurate given some assumptions. It ended up costing 7 minutes and 15 seconds to miss a house, but only 2.5 minutes when a house was added to an existing route of 10 stops. The more stops means less time on average per stop due to the drive from the warehouse. Our next challenge was using the time lost and formulating it into a dollar amount so we could recommend a no-show fee. Adding the no-show and the redelivery gave us a time of 10 minutes. The fee formula was straightforward using dimensional analysis with the assumptions that the car got 17 miles to the gallon, gas cost $2.50 a gallon, the average speed would be about 35 miles an hour, and it took 10 minutes of lost time. Additionally, the delivery person was paid $17 an hour. Doing all of this gave us a rounded late fee of $4. That would be the fair amount the company could charge a no-show customer.